The first collection that I can identify as being sort of my, you know, my first serious effort was in about 1999, I believe. I remember there was the whole Y2K paranoia at that time. I think it was in late 99. I presented maybe about a dozen paintings, portraits that had graffiti backgrounds or motifs of doorways in Brooklyn, rust, and sort of an urban decay type of theme behind the sitter or the subject. And I think it was the first sort of step towards a more mature approach to art for me. This painting is called Her Story, and it's a group of four women, incredibly talented and intellectual women who live in Washington, D.C., four friends. I had an amazing time with this painting because it was part of a series I did specifically in Washington, D.C., which is an extremely interesting city because of the politics. There's such a wide spectrum of experiences there. And of course, you know, the seat of power of the country is there. But there's also, you know, all these experiences of you know, people who've had a lot of challenges in their life, a lot of hardships to overcome. And I think that the women in this painting represent facets of everything about the experience in Washington, D.C. I was doing a lot of commercial work before that. I was doing storyboards for television. I was doing, you know, book covers and newspaper things. And it was always me making work to satisfy somebody else's needs. And it was the first time that I put together some paintings that were just exactly what I wanted to do and which made sense to me at that time. The fact that in this painting the women are facing away from each other, so you can get into each of their individual personas, but you can also see them as a collective and as a group. I kind of like almost that romantic idea from movies where when you're cornered, you sort of fight back to back. And I felt like that was kind of part of what this pose really transmits, is like, you know that person has your back, essentially. I think that first collection was the first step in this journey that I've continued for the last 16 years or so. I sort of thought of the idea of, again, a portrait about somebody that reflects a little bit about their life story, their history, their background. And I think the collage elements sort of help to fill in a little bit of that. I love history, I love antiques. And so a lot of these pieces are literally all having to do with communication. And this is, again, from the show Begin Transmission, which was about communication, about the idea of dialogue, but also exploring in older forms. Like, we use cell phones now, we text message, we email. But at one point, you know, you might have to send a telegraph to somebody. So there's elements of old telegraph kits, Western Union telegram, Morse code, and semaphore signal guides. Here's like a 45 record that's a Morse code instruction course. And I just love that idea of seeing the evolution of communication over time. You know, I'm still looking for that way to successfully combine a fairly academic approach to realism with the street art, with a sense of lyricism. Music is always playing in the back of my head, you know, when I'm painting. I think a lot of the same concerns are there. I'm now trying different things and trying to experiment a little bit and push boundaries, but I can probably identify that series. I think I called it series Urban Portraits back in 1999 as the beginning of this sort of road that I've been on.